I grew up in Montana, went to high school in a very small town with 140 students in the high school, and I had three of the best teachers I've ever had. I think what captivated me were things like the structure of DNA, which had been discovered just a few years before I was finishing up high school, and seeing this beautiful molecule and knowing that somehow it contained all the information of heredity, it seemed to me like an incredibly exciting area that was just poised for lots of new opportunities.
It was when he went to Caltech for graduate school, however, that Lee Hood's direction fully took shape, crystallized by the advice of his thesis advisor and mentor.
He left me with two dictates that have kind of driven my science since that time. One was the idea, if you want to practice biology, practice it at the leading edge. And the second was, if you want to always be at the leading edge, invent new tools for deciphering biological information.
That advice has served Lee Hood for a lifetime, propelling him to seek out areas where barriers to biological understanding exist and developing the technologies to break down those barriers.
The first tool we developed was a machine called the protein sequencer, and what our instrument did that was different from any others was it was about 100 times more sensitive. We were able to interrogate proteins that had been invisible to biologists' ability to study them in the past.
An even more radical breakthrough was Hood's development of the DNA sequencer, a technology that not only made DNA sequencing 3,000 times faster, but is reshaping the frontiers of biology and medicine.
This is a machine that determines the order of the four letters in the DNA alphabet across the 24 strings of DNA that are the chromosomes that are present in each and every cell. And it is this machine that made possible the Human Genome Project.
Hood was an early advocate of the Human Genome Project, the massive undertaking to identify all 30,000 genes in human DNA and determine the sequence of the 3 billion base pairs that make up human DNA. It's an endeavor that Hood believes will have a profound effect on how medicine is practiced in the future.
In maybe 10 years or so, we'll be able to sequence your entire genome and identify their thousands of genes that could potentially predispose you to disease and come to learn how to circumvent their limitations. And in doing so, design drugs or engineered proteins or cells that can actually prevent those particular diseases.
While traditional biology looks at one or two proteins or genes at a time, Hood has been a leader in the push for a systems approach to biology. At his Seattle company, the Institute for Systems Biology, Hood and his colleagues are developing new technologies and common languages to understand the complex interactions that occur between the many levels of biological information.
The key to biology in the future is going to be the analysis of individual cells and their behavior, and in fact, the analysis of individual molecules.
As the Human Genome Project continues to extend our knowledge of our own biological systems, new challenges will almost surely arise. But for Lee Hood, these challenges only present new opportunities.
The guiding principle has always been, where are frontiers in biology that can be penetrated by technology and invent that technology to do so?